Today morning, people continue to flood the scene of the crime where popular blogger Ibrahim Tusubira, alias Yisma Olexas, was shot dead, expressing fear over the continued killings in the area. It was a somber mood in the neighborhood, as some recounted the sound of the gunshots from the previous night. It's barely a week since the Minister for Labor, Sam Engola, was also gunned down by his bodyguard in Chanja, and this has left area leaders and residents traumatized and perturbed. The local leaders in Chanja Zone Nakawa Division have called for extra security in the area.
We are really disappointed, and we feel that the neighborhood around the owners of the apartments and the entire community, at least we need security rights first. Second, those who can manage the cameras, we need cameras, really we need them, because we could get the starting point. Otherwise, what I recommend is that our police around, from Chanja to Kisasi, we are in networking with them. They do their best to see that security is
kept. Upon resident, at least to ensure that we light this area. Maybe these dark spots contribute much towards the crime within the community. So once we increase the light, maybe it will help to save many of prominent people in the near future.
Yisma Olexas' gruesome murder happened at around 9:20 last evening as the deceased approached his home in Chanja Central Zone. There were moments of tension after the news broke out on the various social media platforms. Social media was awash with images of Yisma Olexas' body covered in blood, sitting in a car, wearing a Lakers jersey and a suba wrapped around his neck. Later, Kampala Metropolitan Deputy Police Spokesperson Luke Owesijire confirmed the shooting and said detectives at Kira Road Division Police Station were investigating the attack.
Police at Kira Road are still investigating the incident that happened yesterday at about 9 p.m. in the evening in Chanja Central Zone. It is alleged that one Sura Ibrahim, also known as Ismail Access, popularly known as Jaja Ichuli, was shot while he was in his motor vehicle UBK213D as he approached his premises in Chanja Central Zone. According to information, the preliminary investigation showed that the shooter was a lone gunman, and after the shooting he walked away slowly until he disappeared in the dark.
Police reports indicated that an unidentified gunman armed with an SMG opened fire on the vehicle, resulting in the fatal shooting of Tusubira Ibrahim, who was in his motor vehicle, registered number UBK213D, with his driver Waswa Mathias, who seems to have escaped unhurt.
We had a driver, Waswa Mathias. He's currently into our custody for different reasons, as we take his statement, and him being the only witness, he's also pretty much under protection.
As a precautionary measure, the area was cordoned off in the night to ensure the safety of the public and to facilitate the ongoing investigation process. Police gave assurance that no stone will be left unturned in these investigations until the culprits are brought to book.
All under way to have the assailant arrested. We have so far recorded statements from many witnesses, and I've got in this witness account. And efforts are underway to have the car examined for any evidence that could have been left behind by the attacker. The shell casings were recovered, which are now at our laboratories for analysis. We are also making efforts to have some CCTV footages recovered from the neighborhood, especially the private CCTV footages who was already in that route that leads into his premises.
Ibrahim Tusubira, popularly known as Isma Olexas, was the president of the Uganda Bloggers Association, where he was elected in 2021. He has been remembered as one of the biggest and most recognized online political analysts in Uganda. Olexas came back to Uganda in 2015 after spending close to 10 years in Sweden, where he had moved for greener pastures in 2005 after he had been in Uganda as a businessman before he became a blogger. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.